is not a known unknown place for you. You know about Goa and all, but this time it's an additional this responsibility that you have there in Goa with the likes of Trinamool Congress Party. How do you see this responsibility in Goa being given to you?
Good morning, brother. Thank you for being with me today. For me to come back to Goa now and to try and do something for our local Goans has always been in my heart. For me, for the last 30 years, my tennis has taken me away to play international tennis tournaments. But when I played as an Indian. I played for the Tiranga. I also played for our local people in our country. So when you actually look at 30 years of playing tennis, I have served the people through my profession. Now that I've retired from tennis, now it's to come back and deal with hard issues. When you're dealing with water, potable water, 6 talukas out of 12 talukas don't get proper drinking water. To me, that's a big problem. Especially when you have water in abundance, you have so many beautiful rivers here. Rainwater harvesting is something that can be done. In our traditional Goan culture, we have pans that actually collect water. Are they being used is the question. Are the local people getting to use the facilities of our rich Goan state? To me, to come back now and deal with issues like fair trade for fisher community, good governance for them, to give them subsidized rates for their equipment, to give them subsidized rates to repair their equipment, good surveillance of our waters, our backwaters, our rivers, our oceans, to make sure that bull trolling and to make sure that LED lights are not being used by other state boats. So then when you look at the last decade, our fishing community and our fishing has deteriorated by 85%. To me, that's a huge issue, especially when fishing is such a big livelihood for our locals. I come from South Goa, and in there, in Veli, Tolikanto, Asolna area, fishing is a huge livelihood for the locals there.
Okay.
Also, when you look at garbage and waste, there's a big issue there also that direct has links to the fishing community. Much of pollution and so much of waste is being thrown in our rivers, which then eventually go into our oceans. So environment is a big issue. We have such a beautiful coastline. But when you look at the quality of air now, because of industry, when you look at the coastline, all the waste products going in there, especially in the Kalangut, Baga, Kandolim area, because of the high inflow of tourists, it's important to have that tourist dollar, yes. It's important to have that tourist rupee, yes. But at the same time, you've got to preserve our environment. The other issues that are such basic necessities, brother, is electricity, roadways, network, healthcare. There are so many issues that I can go on about. Safety for women. It's such a major issue exactly where we're sitting right now in Kalangut. Because of the inflow of tourists and people coming in the season, there is such a big issue there. So for me, I find that there's a lot of good work to do. There is a lot of resources and rich resources that we have in the state of Goa that can be used using good governance to create jobs for our youth. And even the wealth that we create using our natural rich resources, good governance can make sure that wealth can go back into the Goan community. So there's a lot to be done.
1.5 months, though, basically you can say another 2.5 months to go down the lane for elections. Can TMC be the change in Goa?
We have the will for good governance. At TMC, we have the will to do good for the people. Yes, it is lots of parties are here, whether the independent parties, whether there's Congress, whether there's the BJP, whether there's Aam Aadmi Party, whether there's TMC. Everyone is trying to do good for the community, but when you actually look at it, who has the will for good governance? TMC is a new party here. Leander has a history behind us. TMC has a history in West Bengal. Everyone's wondering whether the TMC coming into Goa is a Bengal party. No, sir, we are not. TMC in Goa is a Goan party. All our leaders in the TMC are from Goa. I feel that in Goa, we don't need governance from other states. in Goa, we need governance from Goa. It's Goans for Goa. If Goans can come and do good work for Goa, use the rich resources, have a will for good governance to make the quality of the lives of our people better, then we can use our rich resources in Goa to give back to our Goans. So what I'm trying to say is that it's a circle of life. We Goans must come in and do good for our people, create opportunities for our people, create jobs, good air, subsidized education, bring in potable drinking water, safety for women. The mining issue is a huge issue. 35,000 crores is just a figure that the Supreme Court has said that needs to be returned to our state. In our state of Goa, our total debt is 25,000 crores approximately. So if you look at that, not only can the debt of our state be paid off, but you will still have a surplus if that 35,000 crores is given back to our state. My question is, how much has been given back to our people? Not much. There is a need for good governance in our state, where Goans for Goa will create opportunities using our rich resources and do good for our people.
What I've done your study very well as far as Goa is concerned. At the same time, how can TMC convince the Goans? When you bring out your full report or full things which you would like to place in front of Goans, saying that we would like to do this, we can do this for Goa, we can get this back to Goans, and would TMC be able to convince Goans?
That is a great question. I feel that it is an uphill battle for us. I feel that coming in as a new party, everyone is wondering what different can the TMC do. Everyone is wondering is, will the TMC go into a coalition? Will the TMC be governed by Bengal? Will the TMC do good for our Goan people? Well, I can assure you that the TMC in Goa will be governed by Goans. Local people, women and men who are putting their hearts and their passion, just like I am, to do good for our fellow brothers and sisters. I think that is the important part, is the will for good governance, honest governance, to do good for our people. Now, how do we do that? How do we convince the people? By coming out and showing the people the leaders that we are bringing on board. When TMC first came in, before I joined, being a new party, we did not even have a footprint in Goa. So we have gone out and spread the word, whether it's through social media, whether it's through news channels, whether it is through the media, whether it's through the hoardings, whether it's through our senior leaders that we have chosen first. We first had to choose some leaders who were from Goa to create a footprint. So in the beginning, we had a huge spike. We had an awareness of TMC in Goa. Then through the Diwali days, 8 days, there was a plateau. Whenever you have a spike, there's a plateau. But I can assure you that through that plateau, we have worked hard to build what I call a dream team. In that, we have demarked 40 constituencies, and in many of those constituencies, we have worked hard to interact and try and bring on good leaders. For me, this is the important part. It's not to try and get leaders from different states. It's important to have leaders from Goa, who's not only one generation, but two generations have worked for our community. Who leaders from Goa who are really passionate about doing good for the people. Not just people who do bakbak, but people who are actual doers. For me, I feel 5 major issues are really important here that can create a great quality of life. What are they? Potable drinking water. Fair trade and good governance for our fishing communities. Safety for women. Job opportunities for our youth. And in that, I feel that the 5th one is to look after our environment and give a quality of life to our people. These issues have to be addressed individually. These issues have to be looked after. And one of the most important one, the 6th one, was mining. Mining is a huge source of wealth for our state, using the rich resources that we have to create job opportunities for our youth, to create a wealth that can go back into our communities, go back into our local people. I feel these are some major issues to look at.
How has been the interaction, your interaction with local communities here? Because you have traveled from south, now you are in north. You have been meeting people along with the local TMC leaders. How has been that bond of sharing love and interaction, or asking them to come closer towards TMC?
You know, it was very interesting coming into politics and joining a couple weeks ago. Was very interesting because the first thing I received was a lot of love and a lot of affection from our local people. And then from a small section of people, I was called an outsider. So I found that very interesting because of the fact that my roots are here in Goa. Yes, I do have a Bengali mother and I was born in Calcutta. But from my paternal side, from my father's side, my roots are here in Polikanto, in Veli, in Asolna. My great-grandparents are born in Tolikanto. My great-grandparents are buried at the Tolikanto church, which is St. Roque's church. Also, my father was born here in Goa. And in that, my passion for doing good for our people really burns deep inside of me. I feel that there are many issues to be looked at, but it's very important to look at each issue individually. It's very important to address each individual issue and find solutions to them. For me, I find when you just look at safety and security, I find that good surveillance is important. I find that whether it's on water or whether it's on land, to have good surveillance to keep our community and our women safe is such an important thing. Is it being looked at is the question. Is someone there to be a doer or is it just bakma? For me, coming into politics is just a different vehicle away from my tennis. My tennis was a vehicle for 30 years to do good for our people. But now, to choose politics to come in, I have a passion and a deep desire to better the quality of life for our people. And that is why I try.
See, it's always saying that we are also looking at the upcoming 2024.
You know, I think for that you will have to speak to our captain, Mamata Banerjee. Because Didi looks after West Bengal. Didi is now building a party here in Goa, which is TMC Goa, which is a separate entity altogether. It will be governed by Goans. It will not be governed by people from different states. It will be governed by Goans in Goa. And that is the difference that the TMC Goa party will bring to you, is that it won't be a governance from West Bengal or Delhi or Gujarat or Tamil Nadu or anywhere else. It will be a governance from Goa.
Any aim, like how many seats TMC is looking at this moment out of 40 in Goa? Oh, it is all 40. We want to contest all 40.
You know, right now we are building a whole team. Like I talked about, of having a dream team. Obviously, there are 40 constituencies. Everyone knows that. Obviously, you're looking at 40 MLAs. Everyone knows that. But how many times has a party won 22 seats? How many times has a party gone out there and made a clean sweep? The last elections is a proof of what the parties that were in Goa have done. There's a history to that. And I think the people are very aware of that history. As TMC Goa comes in, we are a new party. We are a clean party. We don't have any baggage behind us. We are picking leaders from Goa to govern Goa. We are dealing with hard issues like mining, like safety for women, like potable water, like healthcare, like environment, like jobs for the youth, like subsidized education for the youth. The list keeps going on. But we have the will and the desire for good governance to better the quality of life for our people. And that is the difference of TMC Goa.
Last time, they have been saying that 10 years down the lane, TMC's presence was there in Goa for a short span of time. But after that, the TMC in Goa, you can say, was almost like dead. Now TMC has awakened up suddenly. What is your say on that?
You know, I feel that Goa is a very unique state. Politics in Goa over the last 30-40 years has been very intricate. I feel that the last elections and the previous elections goes to show on how either people are now believing in a coalition or people are believing that politics in Goa can turn any which way. For me, it doesn't. The relevance is about now. The relevance is about doing good for our people. And over history, that has never changed. in history, some of our greatest leaders have philosophies to good, do good for the people. In Goa, we have such a rich natural resource, and my focus is in that. As Goans, we don't have to look outside Goa for help. We need to look within Goa and use these natural rich resources, and using good governance, create a quality of life for our people. What I'm trying to get at is, sometimes you must study that it's not about what your state or your country can do for you. Sometimes you must study what you can do for your state, your country, and your people. And that is where the difference is. Most people try and do only for themselves. I feel good governance is, yes, doing good for yourself, but using your vehicle and your brand and the leadership, that position that you have, to do good for your people.
Finally,
that is the difference.
Finally, as we wind up, and you have a long way to go, what would be your message to Goans till you move towards the final destination, that is the assembly election?
You know, my message to the Goan people is to look in history and to look at the issues that are relevant today, and to then choose the individual or to choose the party that has the will to do good governance, to do good for the community. Choose a Goan party, choose Goans to rule Goa. Choose Goans to make a difference to our Goan fellow people. Our brothers and our sisters need a quality of life. Basic essentials, water, roadways, electricity, network, healthcare, safety for women, jobs, education, the list can go on. But some major issues, five of which I mentioned to you, the local Goans can look within our state and look at Goa being with rich resources, being a shining example that we Goans are self-sufficient to look after our community. I feel that if we Goans use our rich resources and make Goa a golden state, we can be an example to every other state in India on how good governance can create a quality of life for our people, and good governance can make the difference where a state can shine compared to when a state can be used. There's a big difference.
Leander, it was nice talking to you, and thanks for your valuable time. Thank you very much.
Thank you for having me, and God bless.